Hello and greetings from Iceland. Like most of us know already, eruption number 8 on the Reykjavik Peninsula started yesterday with an extra amount of magma that had been accumulating under there for some time. So the eruption started stronger than any other eruption before in this area, or when it comes to magma volume, or just as we feared, and I had mentioned before, totally uncontrollable situation. That left us with no time to modify lava barriers and such, but we can however say now that they did rescue the town this time. It's no doubt about that. So this became a dramatic day, and a busy day for me since I needed footage from the eruption, and drive 400 kilometers in order to get it in time, so I could offer you a bit more than just the news footage, or footage from the edge of the closed area that got evacuated. This distance is not doing much for me, or my first attempt, plan A, but I had to go to plan B, that is actually a story on its own, and good material for a separate video that I will make soon. So even though I didn't get the beginning of the eruption, I got some important bits for the big picture, and necessary to show you the dramatic landscape changes we are going through. And I do have a recent video online that is showing the landscape around the barriers in details just a few days ago, and that landscape is no longer present around Grindavík. So now it's time for a damage report. This is the crater that erupted for 57 days and recently stopped. It marks also the highest point on the Sundhnúkur crater row, and we wanted the fissure to open up to the north from it rather than south, since the defense walls around Grindavík were at some places barely holding what came up during the last eruptions. But most of the lava did however flow towards the town, perhaps 70-80%, since the most powerful part of the fissure was stretching a bit further south than we expected. So things were a bit easier at the north part, like the Grindavík Highway, where the Blue Lagoon Junction used to be. That spot has been hit 2 times with lava and fixed, but it was way less lava that came down there this time, just this little tongue that might crawl over the road today in front of the gap in the lava barrier that was filled up yesterday. And this means that it will be easy to reopen the Blue Lagoon, just remove the gravel again and open the road. And all infrastructure around there is okay, and it looks as it's going to stay like that, so we have no worries there. But this bit of the road that leads up to the craters, I think I can say that I won't be driving that one again. And the bad news is that the town is now around 80% surrounded with lava. And the last kilometer of this road into Grindavík is no longer there. And even the new road into the town is submerged with lava. But as usual, we will just put some gravel on top of the lava and drive over it in a few days. And as soon as I can get closer, I want to remake the video that I made about the lava around the town. Those clips will become the before clips, but when I made the video just a few days ago, they were categorized as the after clips. And those before and after images that I have been collecting, they are one of the main reasons why I'm investing so much work into this. I even have drone shots from the day before this all started, November 9th, and it's going to be lots of work to browse through my whole collection to make those before and after shots into a timeline, demonstrating the dramatic changes around here, from the old landscape to a new landscape that was only with us for a while, until we got something new, again. So my documentation is not just about to film the red stuff, although it is challenging and a necessary part of the story. And yesterday, we were perhaps witnessing one of the most dramatic changes we have seen in this area, since this part of it has been totally submerged with lava, or the north entrance to the town, and the so-called Northern Light Road from the Blue Lagoon to Grindavík. That road is gone, and there is a radar station there with a large antenna, and one of the cables that holds it up is gone, but it should survive it. And the lava has already flowed over the so-called Nesvegur road to the westernmost part of the peninsula. I could not fly over that area yesterday. I got bad weather conditions, lot of smoke, and it might be that I will do those shots later today after this upload. So we have lost 2 roads already, leaving us with only one way into town, or the South Coast Road from east, and it looks now as the lava won't reach that road. But it all depends on how fast this eruption will power down, and the temporary pylons that fed the electricity into Grindavík were lost. But there are generators in town, supplying power to companies that have been operating there. So it might take a few days to reconnect the town, but what we have is literally a huge pond of lava in front of the defense walls north of the town. And those walls are literally now our last hope for the town to survive in some form. And although things look a bit hopeless very often, the stranger situation we get here, the more I get convinced that the worst case scenario could be a major tourist attraction someday or after this chapter comes to an end. But the community, it will never be the same. And it's been a journey on its own to face the facts and accept them. And as usual, I will be leaving links to help you to see the big picture, since I did not manage to cover all angles in yesterday's tour. I had to deal with low visibility, rain and more problems, but I came back with a good travel story, but a bit too long for this update that I wanted actually to upload yesterday, but I was just too tired when I got back around midnight to Reykjavik. And the status now is that I believe the biggest threat we face is the lava pond in front of the town and the ponds by the craters. They can suddenly take off. And although the media has been celebrating the survival of the town today, that wouldn't be there if it wasn't for those structures. The pressure on them is enormous right now, and one little gap could mean that we would lose the town or big parts of it forever. So I won't be celebrating anything for the next days, but I'm glad that those structures did what they did. And as we see on the webcams, it's still plenty of lava coming up. And this eruption is not slowing down as fast as I expected, and we might just as well have one or two craters erupting for the next weeks. It is estimated that 15 million cubic meters of magma has already entered the surface, leaving us with 5 million cubic meters down there, or more than enough to cause a lot of damage. But as for tourism, this has not caused any flight delays. We don't expect any. There were a few explosions yesterday when the lava hit groundwater, but that was just a short period, and the Blue Lagoon will remain closed until the worst is over. And this time, they don't have to wait for the road to be fixed as things look now. But as for volcano tourism, it is impossible to get anywhere close by this place in a car, and it is in fact forbidden to go anywhere near this. But I will say more about that in my next update very soon. Those series of events that we are going through now, they have proved not to help the tourist industry, like the first three eruptions did, and Icelandair laid off over 80 employees yesterday. So the tourism industry has seen better days. And as for the town itself, it has been reopened for emergency services. There are a few sheep there that will be moved away from town, and some unprocessed fish that needs to be moved to other factories. So people there are just doing what needs to be done. And as for the future of the town, it is just so hard to say. This might be the last round in this chapter, but we might get 50 more eruptions. No one can say. Only thing we can do is to remain hopeful or at least some kind of future. And after this upload, I'm going on the road again, get as much footage as I can to work with, and you can expect a new update tomorrow. And finally, many thanks to my channel supporters who made this possible to invest so much time in this for this eruption number 8. That is only a part of a longer story, and I feel as there should be at least one person documenting this from the beginning to the end, especially when it comes to before and after footage. And after this eruption, I'm hoping to get some time to start to edit those bits together. The old Grindavík and the new Grindavík. And until my next update, I want to remind you about the subscription button if you haven't joined this little community here already. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.